Hi, my name is Orla O'Brien, and I'm an assistant scientist at the Anderson Cabot Center for Ocean Life at the New England Aquarium, and I'm the aerial survey logistics coordinator for the aquarium. We're here today planning to fly an aerial survey out to the areas south of Martha's Vineyard and Nantucket. So the type of survey that we fly is called distance sampling. We have these colored stripes of tape on the wing struts. So what our scientists do is they're sitting next to these wing struts, and we're flying along track lines. And when we see an animal, we mark how far away from the plane it is. And that helps us determine density and abundance and space use patterns of the animals that we see. We're flying all year round, so we can get some really interesting patterns in seasonal use and migration of animals.
I'm Trevor Lowy. I'm a pilot for AbWatch. I fly the Skymaster and help maintain them here.
So this is our 1967 Skymaster, one of four we have here. Most of the airplanes that we fly are Vietnam veterans, actually. They were airplanes flown over there doing low altitude surveillance and reconnaissance, much like we do today with the right whale stuff, with a few modifications, mostly adding photo ports to the windows. It allows us to do everything that we do today. A lot of the flying we do is at 1,000 feet, 100 knots over the water, and it's a great airplane for flying, both engines being front and rear. You can see the rear engine between the two tails. Allows for an unobstructed view looking out the side window, so that the scientists can see what they need to see and take photographs without anything on the wings getting in the way of that. They're very easy airplanes to fly, and they have very good fuel endurance as well. Most of our flights are generally about 5 to 6 hours. And that allows us to do things like going as far offshore as going to the marine monuments to do surveys out there, where most airplanes wouldn't be capable of going out that far and then being able to loiter and spend 4 or 5 hours out there collecting data.
Hi, my name is Catherine McKenna. I'm a research assistant at the Anderson Cabot Center for Ocean Life at the New England Aquarium. So over the last few weeks, we've developed some new protocols to make sure that we're able to clean and disinfect everything during our surveys so that we're able to get up and back and flying again.
I'm Meredith. I'm one of the pilots for AbWatch, and we fly the marine survey flights. It's been neat to work alongside NEA and the scientists, and just get to hear the identification, how y'all can identify, you know, almost immediately, just like what type of animal, what type of whale, or whatever it is. Whereas I'm still trying to look and see, okay, what are we looking at? What am I looking for on the specific, you know, how to identify which species is which. But it's been really neat, really, really fun.
Long-term aerial survey programs like the one at the New England Aquarium are important because they help us monitor changes in animal populations. By collecting standardized data over many years, we're able to recognize trends, tie those trends to oceanographic factors, and hopefully model how things will change in the future.
It's been really interesting to just see the different types of animals that we see out there and the changes throughout the year, and the changes over the years too. A lot of changes since 2011. The amount of animals that we see and the types of animals we see. An increased use of the area by right whales as well. And as an endangered species, it's really important to know how these animals are using their habitat and where they are so that we can better protect them.